I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands,
one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands, one Savior, crucified, risen, and coming again in life and liberty to all who believe. Good morning. How is everyone out there? Okay, let's do it. Life is good. Okay, Susanna's the only excited one. Life is good.
When you have Jesus.
All right. Here we go.
To Canaan's land, on my way, the soul of man never dies. My darkest night will turn to day where the soul of man never dies. He rose his glory there for me where the soul of man never dies. And I will spend eternity where the soul of man never dies. Dear friends, there'll be no sad farewell. There'll be no tear dimmed eyes where all is peace and joy and love and the soul of man never dies.
He loved like me to cross the foam
where the soul of man never dies.
It shines to light the shores of home
where the soul of man never dies.
My life will end in endless sleep
where the soul of man never dies. Soul of man never dies.
No sad,
there'll be no sad farewell. There'll be no tear dimmed eyes where all is peace, is joy and love, and the soul of man never dies.
Y'all may be seated. Good morning again. What a beautiful day. Want to thank everybody that came out yesterday and helped put in a pipeline. Wow, I'm excited. We're going to have water where we can have plants and trees and grass. And it's going to be different up here. Thank you, Lord. And I want to thank Brother Doug. He is one of our trustees, and he is, praise God for him. He's hanging stuff in bathrooms and things we need hung, and he hung the picture back under here. And if you haven't looked at that picture, that is an awesome picture. It's got hidden stuff. It's got the tomb hidden in it. It's got the chalice. It's got people. I mean, there's all kinds of hidden things. That's an awesome picture. Is there anybody here that has never been here before? If there is, stand up and tell us your name. We're glad y'all are here. We have a little gift for y'all. Thank you, Jesus. We're glad you're back. Yes, sir. I love your accent, Shane. My name's Shane, and I love it. You fit right in, Shane. Yes, ma'am. Amen. We're glad y'all are here. We got a gift for y'all. Yes, ma'am. Tammy, we're glad you're here today. We got a gift for you. Do you know anybody here?
I know Tammy.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah, it's been since 2006. Welcome back, Tammy.
We're glad you're here, Tammy. Oh, we got some more. Oh, my gosh. Y'all stand up. My heroes are here. Tammy and Lance and Jace is here today, and we're glad you're here today. Man. They moved off to Ruidosa, but they're still members of our church. We're not going to let them be members anywhere else. Anyone else? We don't want to leave anybody out. Don't be shy. We're going to have a baptisms today. And if anybody's moved to be baptized during our baptism service, man, we can baptize in clothes and boots and jeans and spurs. I mean, whatever you want to do, we can do it. It's about Jesus moving in lives. It's about telling the world that I'm going to serve God. And our church coming behind you and spurring you on and saying, we are behind you. I went and watched my grandson play. He's a senior at Logan High School on the east side of the state last night in Logan. And I hollered so loud I couldn't talk when I left the game. But praise God I ain't speak a little this morning. We're going to have a great time this morning. We got testimonies this morning. God is moving in our church. And we're excited for this morning. So let's stand up and sing praise and worship some more.
How many of you left to tell the story? The story of Jesus.
And his blood?
How many of you like to tell the story? Let's try that again.
Yay.
You know, we're supposed to go out and make disciples. We are supposed to go out and let the world know who Jesus is. And do we do that? When we're at the grocery store, I know my brother Milton here, he'll go to the grocery store, Richard, and he'll ask people, do you know Jesus? Jesus loves you. You know, that's what we're supposed to be doing. That's what we're called to do. Because, you know, one day that person might have been thinking about suicide. A smile also helps. So we need to remember that when we're with people. What does your face say? What does your body say? Do you love Jesus? So let's remember that when you need to go out and love to tell the story.
I love to tell the story of unseen things above, of Jesus and his glory, of Jesus and his love. I love to tell the story because I know 'tis true. It satisfies my longings as nothing else. Story.
Good morning. Man, I've got a lot of things to share. First off, do we have any birthdays out here? Oh, you're giving up? Yes? No?
Were you not born, Elliot?
Two?
Oh, anybody else?
Oh, yay.
Come on, we need to represent this side. All right, let's see. Ladies first. 21.
And I'm holding.
And we'll go with, I'm going to stick with 21 again.
No, that's right.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. May the Lord bless and keep you.
Happy birthday. How about anniversaries? Any anniversaries? Nope. Okay. Nobody liked February. All right. So we normally have a potluck at the end of the month. This is going to be basically Easter, so we're not going to do a potluck. But the following week on March 3rd, is going to be our church anniversary, so we're going to hold our potluck on the following week, and I hope that's okay with everybody. That way, we don't get to hold up your good Easter dinner, and we'll still enjoy a potluck. The blood drive is out there today, and like James said earlier, a lot of people signed up, but unfortunately, they didn't show. So they're willing to take walk-ins. So if anybody's willing to donate, feel free. On the 9th, we're going to have our men and women's fellowship, their breakfast and Bible study. On the 10th, daylight saving time starts. So remember to set your clocks forward or you're going to be late for church. Or early for church, I'm not sure. And on the 17th, we're going to have Casey and Brandy O'Connor as our guest speakers, and I'm sure that's going to be really cool. They're going to be talking about their missionaries in Africa, so we can learn a lot through them, I'm sure. The 24th is going to be Palm Sunday, and the 31st is going to be Easter Sunday. So also, anyone who's involved in our play, Francine is going to have a practice right after church, so please stick around and make sure you meet in the front, and we'll all get together and have a practice for that. And I want to do something a little different here. If it's all right with everybody, I'd like to say a quick prayer for our service. Lord, we come to you today, and we know you're in this house, Lord, and we ask that you would be with each and every one of us, Lord. We ask that you would be with James, Lord, give him the words to speak, and Lord, we ask that you give us the ears to hear, that we may take all this in and grow from it. We ask this in your name. Amen.
Children?
And the youth may be dismissed. Thank you.
Jesus loves the little children, all the children of the world. Red and yellow, black and white, they are precious in his sight. Jesus loves the little children of the world.
All right, let's go ahead and we'll stand.
Please rise if you're able. If you don't feel well or your health precludes it, it's okay to stay seated.
Oh, yay.
Let Cindy get her Mando. It's good to have Cindy back on the Mando this year. Makes me happy. Thanks, Cindy.
You're welcome.
All right. Three men on the mountain. In D. Ready? And three men on the mountain. Up on Calvary, the man in the middle was Jesus. Died for you and me. Left was a sinner man. On the cross he bled. He could have been forgiven, but he mocked the Lord instead. You say you are the Son of God, but they nailed you to a tree. Come down from there and save us, if God your Father be. Three men on the mountain, up on Calvary. Man in the middle was Jesus, and he died for you and me. The man on the right was a sinner too, but he was sorry for his sins. He begged the Lord's forgiveness, and Jesus said to him, fear not your earthly death.
All may be seated for this song.
Bless the
people ask me, how do you describe God with one word? How do you describe Jesus with one word? There's only one word that can describe him, and it's love. Love. And that's hard for a danged old cowboy to love. It's hard for a cowboy to shed tears because we're raised to be tough. Don't show emotions. Oh my gosh, I lived a lot of years with baggage, just baggage in me that I didn't even realize was there until I finally turned my life. I was born again. It's so powerful. That love. People need love the most when they deserve it the least. That's so profound to me. And the world wants to run people down when they do things wrong. They want to put them under the bus. They want to hurt them. They want to. But that's when a Christian steps up and says, hey man, I love you and I'm here for you and I'm going to help you get where you need to be. Who's ever been there? Who's ever been there when you needed love? If you don't raise your hand, I'm sorry for you. I feel sorry for you. Because you've been there. You may not have known it. I'm going to read some this morning, then we're going to have some testimonies, then we're going to baptize. Like I said, if anybody wants to be baptized this morning, we can do it. I tell you, it's a special time to tell the world that, hey, I'm going to follow Jesus. I'm tired of following the world. I'm tired of living for self. And I'm going to go live for Jesus. That's what it's about. Father God, help me get through this. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, I just want to thank you for another beautiful day. And I ask you to help me get through this message, Father, to keep my voice where I can speak, Father God. I just thank you and I praise you for that love you give all of us. And Father, I just ask you to fill this place with your love this morning. That people's hearts would be soft and they would see, let the scales of all of our eyes fall to the ground, that we can see the truth, Father, that we can grow closer. Father, I need to grow closer to you. I want to grow closer to you. And I ask you to move in a mighty way this morning. Father God, I thank you again for the opportunity to come here and share your word. I thank you for all those that are here. And we give you all the glory for all you've done for us. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. And all God's people said, amen. So I'm going to start in Romans. You know, Romans is the longest book that Paul wrote. And he wrote it to the Roman Christian church. And it's pretty powerful what he says. I mean, a lot of people when they come to want to start growing in their walk, I tell them to go read Romans. Because it speaks the truth. And it starts out in Romans 6:1. It says, what shall we say then? Shall we go on sinning so that grace may increase? By no means. We are those who have died to sin. How can we live if it any longer? How can we live in it any longer? Or don't you know that all of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus was baptized into his death? Wow. We were therefore buried with him through baptism into death in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly also be united with him in a resurrection like his. For we know that our old self was crucified with him so that the body ruled by sin might be done away with, that we no longer be slaves to sin, because anyone who has died has been set free from sin. I hear so many people say, and it just breaks my heart. They run around and they say, oh, we're all sinners saved by grace. They justify their sins. They justify their sins. And if we're truly born again, we're supposed to be getting away from that. We're all going to fall short, but man, we shouldn't be justifying a sin by doing that. You see, born again means we have died to self. Today we're going to baptize two precious men of God, and they have died to self, and they're going to go underwater, and they're going to do just what Jesus did. They're going to die to that sin, and they're going to come up. Being baptized don't make you a Christian, but it tells the world that I'm dying to self, and I'm going to live for Jesus. If Jesus come today, are you ready for him? I'm going to be honest. I want you to be honest with yourself. Are you really there? Have you died to self? Like the Word says, are you still living, enjoying life, having fun, doing your thing? Gee, I did that for a long time. I did that for so long. Verse 8 goes on to say, now if we died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. I have no doubt that I'm going to get to go live with him. I don't doubt it this morning. I feel him inside of me. I know where I'm going. My dad, I went to his birthday this Saturday, yesterday, and we had a party for him. He's 88 years old. He's ready to go. He's ready to go. He has no doubt where he's going. And I rejoice because I have no doubt where he's going. His fruits are, they're precious. They're precious. And I know that he may be leaving this world, but he's going to a better place, and I'm going to be there with him someday. And then we're going to live forever. I'm ready for that. Yeehaw. I get to ride the best horses on the face of this earth. I get to go brand with the Brandon crew that brands with the cross. There's not anything any better than that. It goes on in verse 9. For we know that since Christ was raised from the dead, he cannot die again. Death no longer has mastery over him. The death he died in sin once for all, but the life he lives in God. In the same way, count yourselves dead in sin, but alive in God in Christ Jesus. Therefore, do not let sin reign in your mortal body so that you obey its evil desires. Wow. And do not offer any part of yourself to sin as an instrument of wickedness, but rather offer yourself to God as those who have been brought from death to life, and offer every part of yourself to him as an instrument of righteousness. Because you are not under the law, but under grace. Wow. Thank you, Father God. I'm going to stop right there in 7 and 6, and I'm going to go to 8. I'm going to go to Romans 8, and I'm going to start at verse 1. It says this in verse 1, chapter 8 in Romans. It says, therefore, there is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus, because through Christ Jesus, the law of the Spirit, who gives life, has set you free from the law of sin and death. For what the law was powerless to do because it was weakened by the flesh, God did by sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh to be a sin offering. And so we condemn sin in the flesh in order that the righteous requirement of the law might be fully met in us who do not live according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. Wow. There's nothing any greater gift given to mankind than Jesus Christ. Than Jesus Christ. This gets real good right here. It says, those who live according to the flesh have their mind set on what the flesh desires. But those who live in accordance with the Spirit have their mind set on what the Spirit desires. The mind governed by the flesh is death, but the mind governed by the Spirit is life and peace. The mind governed by the flesh is hostile to God. It does not submit to God's law, nor can it do so. You have to be born again to be a Christian. You have to be born again and have the Spirit to be who God calls you to be. You don't just come to church on Sunday morning and sing songs and listen to a pastor and go home and live in the flesh. That's not what a Christian is. You die to self and you live for Him. It goes on to say in verse 8, those who are in the realm of the flesh cannot please God. I don't know about y'all, but my goal in life is to please God. Not self, not Denise, not my parents, not my friends, but I'm here to please God. If I please those around me, I'm in trouble. That's what's wrong with churches today. There's pastors trying to please their people sitting out there listening to them. They're trying to tickle their ears and not run them off and not tell them the truth. Someday they'll get before the Lord and they'll say, well, why didn't Pastor so-and-so tell me that I had to die to self? Why didn't he tell me that speaking the sinner's prayer didn't get me to heaven? It's a hard issue. You're not going to heaven unless you die to self. Born again, like I've been preaching the last month, and die to self and live for Jesus. That's the only way we're going to get there. He goes on to say in verse 9, for whoever you, however, talking to us, are not in the realm of the flesh, but are in the realm of the Spirit. If indeed the Spirit of God lives in you, and if anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, they do not belong to Christ. You know it. You know it when you have been born again. Your life changes. Your wishes change. Your love changes. The whole world around you changes. And you start growing in your walk. I tried to please the flesh plus be a Christian, I thought. For 30-something years, I went to church every Sunday and I thought I was there. I got up and went to the altar and had a pastor pray with me. Forgive me of my sins. I want to be a part of you, Father God. And I want you to come and live in me. But I didn't do it from the heart. I never did have the Holy Spirit come in me. And my life was a yo-yo. It was up and down. Man, I could play the part of a Christian, but I would get with the world and I was a sinner. I would sin and I would be like them. You couldn't tell me apart. Sometimes I'd do good, sometimes I wouldn't. But when you have that Holy Spirit, you want to do good. When you have that Holy Spirit, it convicts you. And it says, hey, you don't need to be doing that. Hey, if you gossip about somebody or tell lies about somebody, the Holy Spirit says, what are you doing? And you can't even sleep at night because of that. It's so powerful, that Holy Spirit. It's so powerful. Verse 10 says, But if Christ is in you, then even though your body is subject to death because of sin, the Spirit gives life because of righteousness. And if the Spirit of Him who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you, He who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies because of His Spirit who lives in you. I'm excited about that. I'm not going to die. I'm not going to die. I'm going to live forever. This body is going to go back to dirt. But I'll get a new body. And I'll get to go live in a place. It's not going to be in clouds. Oh my gosh. We're going to live here for 1,000 years. And we're going to serve God. I believe. Why would Jesus be coming on a white horse with all those saints on horses? I mean, He's got to have a little cowboy in Him. I mean, it's like, I'm excited about that. I'm tired of riding Bronx. I'm ready to ride the best horse flesh on the face of the earth because that's what God has. Huh, Jace? Yeah. Yeah. Woohoo. There's nothing better to look forward to. There's no greater gift given to mankind. It goes on to say in verse 12, therefore, brothers and sisters, we have an obligation. That's me and you. This Bible was written for the church. This Bible was written for the church, not the world. So when we read it, it's talking to us. It's talking to us. So it says, therefore, brothers and sisters, we have an obligation. But it is not to the flesh to live according to it, but for it, if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the misdeeds of the body, you will live. You will live. For those who are led by the Spirit of God are the children of God. The Spirit you receive does not make you slaves so that you live in fear again. Rather, the Spirit you receive brought about your adoption to sonship, and by him we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit himself testifies with our spirit that we are God's children. Now, if we are children, then we are heirs, and heirs of God, and co-heirs with Christ. If indeed we share in his sufferings, in order that we may also share in his glory. We're co-heirs with Christ. Do y'all realize that? I mean, like, that's so powerful to me. That's so powerful to me. I'm going to stop right there. I want to ask Brother Ethan to come up here. I want to tell you, I told Denise, I said, I've got to know these two men that's about to come give their testimonies. It is an honor to get to baptize these two men this morning, because they are my heroes, and they are truly born again, and they are truly sold out for Jesus, or they wouldn't be up here. And I'm excited. So I thank you, Ethan, for giving your life to Jesus. I'm going to turn this over to you.
Well, I definitely don't want to be up here. So, and thank God for Pastor James being up here every weekend.
Excuse me.
So I'm Ethan, for anyone who doesn't know. Me and my wife came to this church a year ago in March, and it's been a blessing, and I'm going to share my testimony. Do my best to, anyways. So Pastor James wanted me to share my testimony for a little bit of time, and I have put it off. And 2 weeks ago, I was driving to check some waters, and you know, I looked around, and there were, you know, some fresh calves standing in shoulder high grass, and the song King of Kings was playing on the radio, and started crying. And we'll get to why here in a bit, but that's kind of what started this, me being up here. So anyways, I was born in Briggsdale, Colorado. It's where I lived my entire life until up to last year. Had a pretty rough childhood. Family was not together. Ever since I could remember, it was just fighting, and door slamming, and some physical abuse and all that stuff. So that's kind of what I grew up with as a kid. Then 2011, I shattered my elbow. That changed my life. At age 11, shortly after there, I was introduced to porn and addicted to porn. as a child. So a lot of hard things that went on in my childhood. Not something that I wish upon anyone else, but definitely not something that I'd change now. It all happened for a reason and made me who I am. My dad finally left in high school after a good bout of alcoholism, and he left when I was in high school, and that kind of altered my life a little bit also and changed my decisions. I had scholarships to go play football, and I chose not to give myself to my schooling and didn't have the grades to go. I always viewed myself as a failure for that, and so did everyone else. But life went on, and God brought me men to look up to and to learn from. Those men weren't godly men, but they were good men. They instilled values in me and the value of hard work. And now I am able to show those men what it's like to lead a godly life. And so I have to praise God for those men. January 2023, we moved here. No, I just skipped a whole part of my life. One second. Okay, January 3rd, 2022, God brought me the love of my life, Abigail, over here in this dress. Most beautiful woman on the planet, I might add. We met on Tinder, which is kind of funny. You know, I think it's crazy that all the people on this earth, and I found the one that was meant for me. And at this time, she was already a woman of God, and I was very lost. And she stuck with me. She prayed for me, and she showed me love when I didn't deserve it. And I, in my lostness, made it so that we lived in sin, and that completely wrecked both of our lives. We faced financial ruin, we faced emotional ruin. You know, Pastor James was talking about baggage. If anyone thinks they don't have baggage, they definitely do when they get married, because I faced it all. I know I couldn't communicate my feelings and my emotions, and Abby really helped me through that, and so yeah, we got engaged July of 2022, and then we moved into my grandfather's house, and we had no money. We were close to $1,000 overdrawn in our debit cards. We had maxed out our credit cards. I was in a pretty bad depression. I wasn't working. I was only working 2 days out of the week. And I had decided, we couldn't pay for propane, so it was 20 degrees in our house, and I was fighting burst pipes. And I really was looking for something, and we had been going to church, but you know, I didn't know what it was. And so every morning, driving anywhere, driving to work, I would listen to King of Kings. And so when that song came on 2 weeks ago, you know, it brought on a lot of emotion, because
what he's done in my life, in our life in the past year. Looking back on that time, no money, nothing in our life. We were fighting. I was emotionally and disconnected from pretty much about everything. Not a very good husband. Finally, God brought about a change. We decided we needed to change and a change and to move. And God opened up a job over here, and we moved. We came down and looked at a job on our credit cards, and 2 weeks later we were down here. And that was a good change, but I needed personal growth, and that really happened when we found this church. We found this church, and I've never met a group of people that have blessed us and showed us love the way that you guys have, and so thank you. So shortly after coming here to church, that was in March, and hanging out with Pastor James and other good men in our church, I was sitting there in my living room scrolling through Instagram, and pretty useless thing to be doing, and a video came up, and it was from a movie, and the guy in the movie was saying Isaiah 6:8. Then I heard a voice from the Lord, and the Lord said, "Who can I send? Who will go for us?" And I said, "Here I am. Send me." And that really hit me in the chest, and the floodgates opened, and I sat there on our living room floor crying, and accepted the Lord into my heart for real this time, and my life changed. I became a better husband and a better friend and a better co-worker and a better worker. All my anger and hurt and pain from the past that I was taking out on my wife all disappeared with hard work. So that was almost a year ago, and I can't even fathom where I'm at right now. My marriage is in an incredible spot. I have a baby that's coming in June. I get to do what I love every day in one of the coolest places to do it. And so when that song came on the radio 2 weeks ago, you know, it's just never doubt what God can do when you allow Him to. And I've really been clinging to Psalms 18:2. The Lord is my rock, my fortress, my place of safety. I run to Him for protection, for He is my shield. His power saves me. I can't wait for our baby to be born and to teach him that the Lord is his rock and his fortress and his shield and his place of safety, because it's pretty hard not knowing that for 22 years. But I'm glad that I learned it this early, and I can't wait for a life of it to come. Thank you.
Wow. You can go put your shorts on, brother. What a day. What a day. What a day to be alive. So precious. Come here, Brother Jake. Brother Jake's not scared of nobody. He wears his shorts and his boots. I like that. Yeehaw.
Hello, brother.
How's it going?
I'm good.
Man, I love this guy. He come in here, and I mean, the first Sunday, I'll never forget. How long you been here?
About 4 months now.
Amen. I remember I got up to preach that morning, and here's this guy sitting right there. I went, man, that's pretty cool. And I've gotten to know him, and he is so precious. He's from, I'll let him tell you about himself. Here's Jake.
How you guys doing? My name's Jake Doherty. I'm from Fernley, Nevada. So I've been in Albuquerque for about 4 months now. Basically, my life changed 4 years ago. It was October 19th, 2019. I started my lineman apprenticeship, hit the road, felt like my back was against the wall, and the only person I could go to was God. I didn't have anybody. I'm an only child, so kind of used to being alone, but the past 4 years, God has helped me to grow up and to be the man I am today. There's been a lot of times I'd be stressed, I'd be depressed for no reason. I don't know why. I guess I didn't really know Jesus until I hit the road. I met lots of people. I worked in 6 different states, been to lots of churches, met lots of good people of God, and they've helped me over the years to grow a better relationship with God and to be where I'm at today. Growing up, I always tried to be someone that I'm not, basically. And giving my life to God has been a life-changing thing for sure. But never thought in my life I'd be giving a speech in shorts and cowboy boots. But here I am. So, but no, I'm thankful for all you guys, the guys I haven't met. Hopefully I'll get to meet you soon, but you guys definitely become a big part of my life and help me finally give the nerve to come up here and to get baptized. This is my first time ever, so. I've always gone to church here and there growing up, but I didn't start going a lot until about 4 years ago. Until I hit the road and everything changed. So, praise God. It's really about it. Short and sweet.
Amen. You stay here. I tell you, he is so special. I mean, like, he left home. And he had a goal for his life, and he is on a mission. And that is so powerful to me. And then we've got to go eat and do stuff together. And hey, there's a friendship. There's a lifelong friendship there. And without this church, where would these guys be? Would they ever have the love that y'all showed these guys? Is wow. It's powerful. It's so powerful. Remember, we had a revival in October of last year, and we had Bree and James that did the music. Y'all remember them? And from Desert Rain. And Brother Jake, we went and ate the other day in Albuquerque, and we were talking about music and about stuff, and he said, man, he said, I figured something out. And I said, what'd you figure out? And he said, I got on the church website and I looked at your revival, and them people that were singing at your revival, I went to their church. I worked right there, and I got to know James and Bree. And he said, is that the same people? And I said, yeah. You want to talk to them? Yeah, I don't have their phone number or nothing. I said, I do. So we called. We didn't get James, but you got to call him, didn't you?
I finally called him about a week after.
Yeah. So it's unreal what God does and how he puts people together for his glory. You know what, really? Brother Jake's going to be leaving here probably in April, and it breaks my heart that he's leaving, because I've really grown fond of him, and he's a precious young man. But he's going back. I don't know where you're going.
I don't either.
Yeah, he don't either. He follows the lineman. He does dangerous things up in the air, and praise God for him. But he's leaving here, and he's leaving with the love that he found in his church. And he's going to go in the world somewhere, and he's going to make a difference wherever he goes. And we get to be a small part of that. We get to be a small part of that. And I'm excited for that. I mean, that's what it's all about. Is going into the world. Jesus said, go into the world, baptizing people in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and teaching them my commands. And that's what we're doing here at this church. That's the love. You go ask anybody that comes to this church, the first thing they say to me is, I've never experienced the love that I feel in this church. And it's you guys. It's you guys. You have no idea what you're doing in people's lives. I can sit here and point at marriages, and I can sit here and point at people that I've got to minister to and love, and seen them going through heck, and they didn't know if their marriage was going to last, and they didn't know what was going to, but the love of this church, the love of Jesus, brought them back together. And that's what we're about. That's what we're about. So let's go do this, brother. You ready?
Yes, sir.
You got a towel?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, perfect. I'm ready. Wow. Could the elders come up? We got some more towels. Blankets? Blankets? Okay, praise God. It's okay. I told Sister Abigail, I said, you're welcome. I need to ask Pat, would you come over here and take pictures? Her film didn't work last time. You get your camera fixed? Praise God. All right, we got it covered. It wouldn't hurt for two people to take them, huh? So who wants to go first? You ready? Let's go, brother. You get the dirty the water up. Let's go.
Perfect.
Is it warm? You can't stand there very long. Is it nice? Just go put your feet.
Nice.
I know you would. That's who you are, brother. Move up just a little bit. Okay, I won't drown you. I'm just gonna hold you here.
Not yet.
Okay. I'm gonna let you back in, and I'll let you up. Brother Jake, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I am excited. Here you go, brother. God bless you guys. I don't know if this tank's big enough for you, brother. You may have to bend your... Oh, yeah, it'll work. I don't want to hit your head. Sister Abigail, I told her she'd come up and help me, and she said, yeah, we may need to hold him under a little longer. And I said, well, you probably know how long it's going to take to get all that out, you know. I love you, brother. Man. Brother Ethan, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Oh, man. You know, these guys could come play on my football team anytime. Congratulations, guys. I'm excited for what God's fixing to do in y'all's life. These guys, I believe God is fixing to call these two men into ministry someday. I mean, they have that walk, and they have that hunger to serve Jesus, and I see that happen. And I'm excited for that. I'm excited. So, Valencia County Cowboy Church, I want you to know that when we baptize people, I say this, but we have to really understand that when people come forward in our church and they get baptized, they die to self and they come back. It shows that they have changed, that they're going to serve Jesus. They've left the old behind. And it does something that gives us something to do. It is something we have an obligation to do as a church. And that as we are supposed to spur them on. We're supposed to be there through the thick and thin. We're supposed to be there when they need us. We're supposed to be there to help them and to encourage them. And we need to do that with everybody here. We need to be there for each other. Times are going to get worse. And when times get worse, we see what's going on out in the world. It gets to be a free-for-all out there because they don't know Jesus and they don't know what's going on. And they get angry and they get mad. But when times get tough in a church, we just get closer together, loving each other and supporting each other and being there for each other. That's what this is about. I hurt for the world when things start turning south like they're doing because it's going to be chaos. But when you know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, there's no chaos. There's peace, love, patience, comfort, love, joy. That's what that Holy Spirit does for us. So I'm going to ask y'all this morning as a body of Christ, Valencia County Cowboy Church, will you support? Will you encourage? Will you spur these two guys on as they walk in the walk God has called them to walk? And if so, would you please say, "We do," real loud. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Father God. I'm going to turn it over to Brother Jeff. You guys can go get out of your wet clothes or you can stay in them, whatever you want to do. It was an honor to get to baptize y'all. Amen. Love you guys.
Okay, so we're going to gather up these cards. Richard, could you come up and pray over our cards for us? Anybody who would like, please come on up and we'll gather around and pray over all these prayer requests. You going to make it?
Father Almighty God, we come to you in the name of your Son Jesus, which is our Lord and Savior. Father, we bring these requests to you. I don't know what's on them, Lord, but you do through the Holy Spirit. Lord, I ask you to take each and every request, Lord, and answer according to your will. Lord, send out the Holy Spirit to each request, to each person that put one of these in, and just let them know, Lord, that you've got this. And we thank you, Father, and we give you praise, Lord, in Jesus' wonderful name. And everybody said, amen.
Amen. We will have a ending song right now, and the elders will be here to pray with y'all up front if there's those that need prayer today. And Brother Richard.